Good morning. Today's liturgy celebrates the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is our pastor, Father Kevin, and our processional song is Sing a New Song, number 550 in the music issue. Please stand for the procession.
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning. This morning we celebrate the 28th Sunday of Ordinary Time. In this Mass, we remember Rosemary Buckley. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. Naaman went down and plunged into the Jordan seven times at the word of Elisha, the man of God. His flesh became again like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean of his leprosy. Naaman returned with his whole retinue to the man of God. On his arrival, he stood before Elisha and said, "Now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Please accept a gift from your servant. Elisha replied, as the Lord lives whom I serve, I will not take it. And despite Naaman's urging, he still refused. Naaman said, if you will not accept, please let me, your servant, have two mule loads of earth, for I will no longer offer holocaust or sacrifice to any other god except the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all your lands. Break into song, sing a praise.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember, Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, is a descendant of David. Such is my gospel for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Circumstances give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus.
The Lord be with you. with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Have you ever heard someone begin a conversation by saying, "Mark my words, listen up and listen carefully," or "a word to the wise"? These are verbal cues that we are about to hear something very important that we should give the speaker our undivided attention. For the words we're about to hear could have a big impact on our life. In the latter half of today's second reading from Timothy, we are likewise directed to pay close attention when we read at the beginning, "This saying is trustworthy," for what we are about to hear could have a huge impact on our spiritual life. The reading continues, "If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful because he cannot deny himself." These are words of great comfort to me. What do these trustworthy words call me to do? What impact do they have on my life? And what direction are they leading me? As Catholics and as Christians, we want to die with Christ, but as the reading aptly points out, to do so, we must first live with him. He must be at the center of our lives. When we have that, everything flows so well with all the others that are in our life. When we find time today in our hectic world to reflect upon our lives, we can ask ourselves, am I truly living with Christ? Is he part of my daily experience, or is he just someone I think about on Sunday at Mass? Am I putting action to my faith, or will it end when I leave Mass this morning? The last sentence is the most powerful for me because it reaffirms that in spite of my sinfulness and unfaithful ways, God cannot be unfaithful to his promise to me. God will remain faithful and be there for me and for you 24/7. He is always ready to listen to our pleas for forgiveness, our petitions, and our prayers. This realization makes waking up tomorrow wonderful because I know that God will be there in the morning, waiting for me, ready to put his hand on my shoulder and guide me throughout the day. Please stand for our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and Son, his words, Lord, glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With humility and confidence, let us bring our petitions before the throne of the Lord.
For the Lord to continue to draw forth holy and faithful servants to shepherd his flock, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the life of every person to be protected and cherished from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God to continue to watch over all first responders and frontline workers, especially on this Faith in Blue weekend, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead who have gone before us to live forever in the presence of God, especially James Perry, members of our Mass Intention Guild, and all our beloved deceased, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For James Davin, for whom our sanctuary candle is lit this week, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions best spoken in the silence of our hearts, for those needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Rosemary Buckley, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and grant them in accordance with your divine will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory song is Sing to the Mountains, number 538.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with these sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of a devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant, Rosemary Buckley, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is How Great Thou Art, number 432 in the music issue.
Consider all the worlds I hands have made.
body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so may you make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Have a handful of announcements. Sign-ups for the Christmas Fair theme baskets are this weekend at the back of the church. Blessing of the animals will take place next Sunday, October 16th at noontime. Our fall decorations are back. We invite you to carve a pumpkin and add to our display on the front lawn. Catholic Daughters is hosting a pizza party on October 20th for women interested in learning about this organization. They're having a membership drive on October 15th and 16th. October is Respect Life Month. Please help us celebrate by taking a baby bottle at the back of the church and filling it with spare change for Abundant Hope Pregnancy Center, or by taking a list of needed supplies for the Doolittle home. People are asking me as they're bringing out the baby bottles as to when they need to be returned. They can be returned anytime when they're filled, or you can bring them back the last weekend in October. Also, after this Mass, or shortly after this Mass, there will be a blessing of the memorial bricks. Bricks that have arrived have been installed. If you ordered a brick for the Memorial Brick Garden, please stop by and see it, and there will be a blessing of the bricks right after the 11 o'clock, right after this Mass. So see you out there if you come out. Also, it's so nice to see another nice day. We're stringing some good days together. A little bit on the chilly side, but that's okay. It's good apple picking weather. If the Patriots aren't playing well, then maybe a little bit of apple picking will be a nice consolation. And someone can to make the apple pies or the apple bettys. So I even do apple bettys. My wife showed me how to make an apple betty a long time ago. So if you want to find out what the difference between an apple betty and an apple crisp, just see me at the end of Mass and I'll tell you. But I'm a one-baked wonder. That's it. I want to wish everybody a wonderful and blessed weekend. And enjoy. Isn't it nice that tonight is not a school night with the Columbus holiday? Yeah, someone's shaking their head. No school, there you go. And so again, have a wonderful and blessed day, weekend, and week. The Lord be with you. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Our recessional song is Now Thank We, All Our God, number 195.